Now that we've explored some of the contexts in which interviews take place, we might have realized that in some of these contexts, there can be differences in terms of privilege, access to resources or technology, money or status between interviewers and those being interviewed. This can create situations in which those being interviewed might find the experience to be uncomfortable, or might even feel some subtle pressure to answer questions in particular ways. For example, giving the answers that they think the interviewer wants to hear, or trying to please the interviewer. Sometimes people remain in interviews even after they've gotten tired and would rather be doing something else with their time, because they don't feel comfortable asking the interviewer to stop the interview, or because they're worried about some negative consequences if they don't finish. In all of these cases, the quality of the information that we gather through an interview goes down if our interviewee isn't enjoying the experience, is telling us what they think we want to hear, or is rushing through their answers to get on to more important activity. Lean research is an approach to conducting field research, including interviewing, which acknowledges that these kinds of dynamics and situations can exist, particularly in cases when we're conducting research in other countries and with people of other cultures, or if we're interviewing people who are significantly younger than ourselves or who have less authority. Lean research seeks to create a better, more respectful, more enjoyable experience for the research participants, who in our case would be interviewees, while also improving the quality, usefulness, and accuracy of the information we gather. We can achieve that by conducting our research and interviewing in a way that reflects the four principles of lean research. These principles are rigor, relevance, respect, and right size. We also refer to these as the four R's of lean research. I'll now briefly describe what's meant by each of these principles in the context of field research, and more specifically in the context of conducting interviews. When we say that lean research is rigorous, we mean that it follows best practices and high standards of quality and accuracy, as defined by the field of the researcher. The practices and standards for rigor in the field of journalists, for example, might be different than they are in the field of economics or anthropology. In each of these fields, however, there are commonly accepted standards for how to conduct research and gather data in ways that ensure the integrity of the research process and the validity of the research findings. In the context of conducting field interviews, being rigorous means that first and foremost, we're taking steps to ensure the accuracy and truthfulness of the information we're collecting. It also means we're taking steps to make sure the data we collect is usable, meaning that it's recorded or documented fully and accurately, that it doesn't contain errors, for example, loud noises in the background that might make an interview recording difficult to decipher when we go back to listen to it. Rigor also involves ensuring the integrity of the data. This means the data is kept safely and securely, so that no one can tamper with it or alter it after the fact, and so that information that is supposed to be confidential or anonymous stays that way and isn't shared inappropriately. In the next lesson, we'll start to look at how to do these things, in terms of specific steps that can be taken in order to make an interview-based research process more rigorous. But first, let's continue with our overview of each of the lean research principles and what they mean. By relevance, we mean research that addresses questions that matter, not just to the researcher or the sponsor of the research, but also to a wider set of people, including those who are being researched and others in their community. This can include community leaders or policymakers, or others who have a stake in the issues affecting this particular place. We call these stakeholders. A relevant research study has the following attributes. It has value to multiple different stakeholders, because it addresses questions and issues of interest or concern, beyond the personal curiosity of the interviewer. It produces findings which are understandable and accessible to different types of audiences, not just academics. This means that the findings are stated in language that's non-technical, that's not full of a lot of discipline-specific jargon, which means that the findings and their implications can be understood by people who participated in the research, as well as decision makers, like community leaders. This is because relevant research is designed not just to answer questions for the sake of it, but also to inform decision-making and action at various levels of authority. So in this way, the research and the results of the research have relevance to what's happening in the places that are being researched, and not just to the debates that are happening in academic settings like classrooms or conferences or journals. Making sure that our research matters has some value to the people who we're asking to participate in it is part of what it means to conduct research that's respectful. Respectful of people's time, their expertise, and the knowledge and information that they're sharing with us by participating in our interview. Research and interviews that are respectful prioritize the dignity of our interviewee and the experience that they have while participating in the research. We want this experience to be a positive one, one that leaves the interviewee feeling valued, feeling heard, and feeling satisfied with the experience of sharing with us. Ideally, they even enjoy it and feel grateful for having had the chance to participate in our study and share their story and knowledge with us. In this way, the Lean Research Framework asks us to go above and beyond the standard approach to research ethics, which simply asks us to do no harm to our research subjects. In other words, for our research to not have a negative effect on them, physically, psychologically, or by exposing them to some types of risks. Lean research says, yes, that's important, but we should strive for a higher standard and for our research to create a positive impact for our research subjects, for it to actually be a worthwhile and valuable experience for them, and not just a way to get valuable data for us. Respectful research also means research that honors a participant's right to be fully informed about the purposes and the nature of the research, and to opt out if they don't want to participate, either from the beginning or at any part in the process once it's started. This means we need a real, meaningful, understandable informed consent process as part of our research. We'll talk more about what this means in Lesson 3. But for now, I want to emphasize the importance of creating a situation in which our interviewee feels really free to not participate if they don't want to, or to just not answer specific questions if they make him or her uncomfortable. Now, this might seem obvious, but there are lots of situations in which people feel obliged to answer questions, even though they don't really want to. Maybe because they're afraid that they might lose access to some services that they rely on, or because they don't want to offend the interviewer or seem difficult. Related closely to the principle of respect is the final principle of right size, which means that the research scope and methods are well suited to the research objectives, the priority of the research to stakeholders, and the potential for impact of the research. This also might seem obvious, but there are many examples of research studies that involve too many people, cost too much, or take far too much time from the research participants when considered in light of the importance and relevance of the research being asked and how that research will ultimately be used. If, for example, we take a full day of a busy micro-entrepreneur's time to have them sit in interviews and tell us every detail of their financial lives, their incomes, their assets, their savings, but our final report will only be read by our boss and our donors, and then we'll sit in a file and gather digital dust, we can understand that this is not very respectful of the time of this entrepreneur. If our study has a narrow purpose and a small audience, a more right-sized interview approach might involve taking 45 minutes or an hour of someone's time, not a full day, for example. So by right size, we mean that what the study involves in terms of time, money, effort, and inconvenience for people is roughly proportionate to the importance, relevance, and potential impact of that study to make a positive change in people's lives. That same entrepreneur might be very willing to give a half day or even a day of her time for interviews if the study is intending to influence the local business or policy environment, if the findings will be shared with financial institutions or regulators in order to make it easier to obtain affordable credit, for example. That could make a large difference in this person's livelihood, and they might be very willing to invest more time in a study that has that purpose, as opposed to, say, a course project for a class that will only be read by the professor. So we can see that making research right-sized is one way in which we make it respectful, particularly of people's time. We can also see that right size and relevance are closely related. And together, the principles of right size, relevance, and respect help to ensure that when we interview someone, they feel encouraged and motivated to tell us the truth and to share with us the kind of information that we're looking for, which, as you remember, is a key aspect of rigor. In this way, the four lean research principles support and reinforce each other. And when we use lean research as a framework to guide our research, it means that we're looking for opportunities to align what we do, not just with one principle or with another, but with all four, even if we choose to start by working on a specific one that feels most important in the context of what we're trying to do at that time. In summary, we can see that lean research is a framework which is made up of four interrelated principles, and it is also an approach to doing research, meaning it involves a set of practices, of things that we do differently compared to conventional research. In the next lesson, we'll be becoming more familiar with these practices, but first, we'll share with you a brief document where you can review some of the key information you just learned about lean research, and also read about some questions that we can ask ourselves to see if the research we're doing or planning to do reflects the four R's of lean research.